Most people think of the UAE as the land of skyscrapers, luxury cars, and brunches that go on for hours. But quietly, and very strategically, it's building something far more transformative, an AI-first nation. From Dubai, our team at ZIWO has witnessed something unprecedented: the systematic transformation of an entire nation into the first AI-native society. What we're about to show you isn't just technology deployment, it's a complete transformation. Today, we're unpacking how the UAE is turning AI into a national advantage and what the rest of the world might want to copy before it's too late. Let's go back to 2017. While many countries were still arguing whether AI was a sci-fi fantasy or a threat, the UAE just appointed the world's first Minister of State for Artificial Intelligence, His Excellency Omar Sultan Al Ulama. By 2019, the UAE National Artificial Intelligence Strategy 2031 was in place, a 10-year plan to lead in sectors like education, healthcare, logistics, and government services. This wasn't just a fancy vision statement. The UAE started embedding AI into schools, startups, and ministries, and invested heavily in digital infrastructures, data centers, and talent. Next came building serious muscle for AI. They started embedding AI everywhere. Schools started teaching computational thinking to six-year-olds. In May of 2025, they made history. They became the first nation to require AI classes from kindergarten to 12th grade. Government agencies redesigned services around AI-first principles. Startups got access to sovereign AI infrastructure, and universities pivoted entire programs toward AI research. The UAE didn't just want to use AI, they wanted to become AI. And then Falcon arrived. In 2023, the UAE made global headlines with Falcon 40B, an open-source LLM built by TII. Unlike proprietary models, Falcon emphasizes transparency. The Falcon family has since expanded, introducing Falcon 2, Mamba 7B, Falcon 3, and Falcon Arabic, which caters to regional dialects. It quickly became a benchmark model, high-performing, multilingual, and transparent. By 2025, Falcon 2 was live, boosting even stronger efficiency and language agility. Falcon isn't just a technology, it's a statement of AI sovereignty. The UAE joined the exclusive club of nations that can build frontier models, protecting its data, values, and strategic independence. And unlike some labs that keep their models locked away like family secrets, the UAE threw open its doors to researchers worldwide. Outside the labs, the UAE is putting AI to work in all kinds of places. In healthcare, AI helps diagnose diseases, manage hospitals, and even predict health trends. Lately, it's diving into genomic research and personalized medicine. Next up, AI that reminds you to drink your water in the desert heat. In transport and logistics, smart cities and autonomous systems are turning blueprints, traffic flows, and energy consumption. In education, AI tutors and adaptive learning are making classrooms smarter alongside AI literacy programs to ensure the next generation knows their way around a neural net. We're talking about seven comprehensive areas: foundational concepts, data and algorithms, software use, ethical awareness, real-world applications, innovation and project design, and policies and community engagement. These aren't random pilot projects. They are part of a unified national strategy, blending policy, tech, and talent, and maybe saving everyone some time in line along the way. So why does all this matter globally? The UAE offers a playbook for countries, especially emerging economies, that want to leap ahead. When a country develops its own AI capabilities with such intensity, it sparks important conversations. From the business angle, every Fortune 500 CEO is asking the same question. If the UAE can build Falcon models that compete with OpenAI and Google, what does that mean for their AI vendor contracts? Are they too dependent on US tech giants? Then the political reality. Some critics worry about AI nationalism and countries building walls around their AI capabilities. However, others argue it's about time we had alternatives to the Silicon Valley monopoly. And lastly, the government dilemma. Here's where it gets fascinating. Western governments are simultaneously worried about China's AI dominance and rushing to reduce their dependence on American AI companies. The UAE offers a third option: advanced AI capabilities from a stable, internationally aligned partner. But here's the UAE's masterstroke. Instead of picking sides, they are building bridges. While others create AI blocks and trade restrictions, the UAE is doing something different. Their Falcon models are open source, meaning available to everyone. They are hosting international AI safety conferences, and the research partnerships span every continent. The creation of the AI and Advanced Technology Council in January 2024 wasn't just about internal coordination. It was about positioning the UAE as a trusted mediator in global AI governance. The message is clear. We're not trying to control AI, we're trying to democratize it responsibly. Then came May 2025, when everything changed. President Trump's UAE visit sparked the largest AI partnership in history, $1.4 trillion in US AI infrastructure over 10 years. The UAE also got approval to build the world's largest AI campus outside the US in Abu Dhabi. The UAE isn't just building AI for itself, it's building it for the world. Now let's talk numbers, because AI sovereignty isn't cheap, but the UAE has turned it into the investment of the century. Since 2017, the UAE has poured a staggering $500 billion, one quarter of its annual GDP, into artificial intelligence, building not just infrastructure, but a nation powered by talent and global partnerships. Three powerful engines drive this momentum. A 5-gigawatt compute campus powering Middle East, Falcon AI sovereign licensing, and world-class talent from Mohammed bin Zayed University. And the impact? Healthcare costs slashed by 40%, smart cities using 30% less energy, financial systems running 5 times faster with 90% fewer errors, and edtech experts projected to soar to $50 billion by 2030. The return on investment? For every dollar spent, 7 come back, alongside something far greater, true economic independence. As 2031 approaches, the UAE's AI ambitions are picking up speed. With Falcon 2 released, expanding computing power, and a louder voice in global AI safety debates, this is more than digital transformation. This is nation-building powered by AI. Whether you're a policymaker, entrepreneur, or investor, the UAE's AI playbook is masterclass in scale, speed, and clarity. The rise of an AI first nation isn't just coming, it's already here. If you found this breakdown of the UAE's AI playbook helpful, or at least a bit mind-blowing, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon. And hey, if you're building customer experience solutions in this AI-powered world, check out what we're doing at ZIWO. Link in the description. Until next time, stay curious.